Hello everyone, my name is Mila, welcome to my channel. I'd absolutely love it if you would subscribe to my channel, like this video and activate the notification bell. And please actually do it. Okay, so this is the part two of my best perfumes of 2020, and this is the niche part. I already did a mainstream perfumes, and I will add it at the end of this video, so after you can go watch the other one if you want to. Okay, so this is cheesy but true. I absolutely love Delina Parfum de Marly. It's just amazing. It has a crisp, fruity opening, but it is, the dry down is so sexy. It's like a lychee rhubarb perfume. But the dry down of it is worth every penny. I get asked a lot to compare this with the exclusive one, and I don't think there is that much difference. I think that they have the same vibe. The other one just has more woody dry down. I think that this perfume is considered like a spring summer perfume, but to me it is a very sexual perfume. The musk dry down on this literally smells like a pussy, like a clean pussy. I know that people get shocked when I say that, and I don't understand why I'm not demonetized, but to me it literally smells like that. And yeah, it's amazing. I think it's very sexual. To me it lingers for days. And I feel like the more you wear it, the more it smells good. Maximum 24 hours until a shower, in my case. But yeah, you know. But I'm sure it could linger more, okay? Okay, next. Okay, so what am I going to do? Okay, let's do these ones. This is my favorite discovery of the year. And obviously, guys, these are more... I would say I have better niche fragrances than that. But these are more the ones I discovered this year. You know what I mean? I need to adapt. Otherwise, every year I will have the same fragrances and that is not going to be interesting. So, Naso Matua. I'm actually adding three. I absolutely love them. They are quite expensive compared to the milliliter, but I think they are totally worth it. My partner cannot smell shit. Like, let's be honest, he can't. But with these... I have like two, three sprays and he can smell them all day. So let me start by this one. This is Black Afghano, which is apparently the name of a... of like, you know, the resin of cannabis. And it smells like woody, to me quite dry and also a little bit herbal. And I just think that this gives a vibe like anyone who talk to me, you're just ghosts and I'm the shit, okay? Yeah, apparently I like stuff that smells like drugs and pussies, you know? Okay, then this one, Absinthe. Okay, so this is a green woody perfume. And it has some undernotes that I cannot really discover. But I really like it. I have to get used to this one. If I'm honest, I got it the other day and I worn it 3 days solid. It has a very herbal, aromatic dry down. That's what I meant. And the packagings of Naso Matua, like, I know a lot of people don't like them, but I think they're absolutely amazing. Like, Delina Parfum de Marly is gold packaging, and these ones are gold. Like, look at that weight. I'm sorry to say, but, like, the fact that the packaging is so minimal, I think the work they made on it is amazing. This one with, like, the more woody cup. Woody textured, this one was just like the plain wood one, and this one is my favorite. This is Naso Matua, how's it called, this one, Blamage, and I love the packaging. It is also again a mainly woody fragrance, but it has also some florals and a little powdery note. Guys, I think you should go try these fragrances. They also have the same signature, so if you like one, you probably like them all. I was recommended Narcotic V. I'm not gonna get this one because apparently it's a dupe for the Michael Kors one that smells like gherkins. I absolutely love gherkins, okay, but I already have the Michael Kors one and also have the Kim Kardashian's first perfume, which also is supposed to be a dupe for a perfume that costs a lot more, so I'm not gonna bother. And it's not my favorite kind of scents. I do like them, but they're not my favorite. Then Kiali Deja Vu. This is like a jasmine, vanilla, sexy, very oriental fragrance. It's also very affordable. for a niche fragrance. I think they are considered niche. Are they? Yeah, I think so. Anyway, this is very good, a very good modern classic. Guys, I struggle talking because of the caffeine. Okay, so basically I should stop the caffeine. I should lay off. This is amazing for a classic woman. It's amazing for an everyday office wear. It's an amazing signature fragrance. I think that this is one of my favorite fragrances of my niche ones. Yeah, I do like Nazomatu and Delina as well. Yes, I'm going in order of what I like, actually. I don't know. I cannot choose. So yeah, I definitely recommend this one. And it has also a very good lasting power. Then, what should I... Okay, so guys. I'm sorry I tricked you a little bit. I put this on the thumbnail just because that I know that it's gonna do clicks. This is Baccarat Rouge 540. To me, it smells medical. It smells also like kind of sea-ish and also kind of sweet-ish. It's very hard to describe. It is a molecular fragrance. You know, people often say that this is good to smell expensive or to go out. I feel like it's more like a gym fragrance to smell more like clean. And yeah, but this is just my opinion. Apparently everyone has a different take on it. Do I think it's amazing? No, but I just added it for the thumbnail and I had to talk about it. I think that the dupe that Francis Kurkdjian did himself, Burberry Her, is cleaner and more interesting. And I also prefer actually the Ariana Grande one. So yeah. And I feel like people who want to argue with me about that are just like, maybe they like this one more, huh? No problem. But I feel like a majority is just because they're pissed off that they spend so much money on a basic packaging. It is good, it projects better than the two other ones and it stays longer as well. But I mean, you know. It's hard to describe, as I told you. So yeah, Francis Kurkdjian, Baccarat Rouge 540. Then, oh my god, I actually love that. So this is Nirmala from Molinar. It is an exotic perfume. This to me smells like... It smells to me literally... Okay, so maybe not everyone will agree, but it smells to me like dried mangoes from a brand sold here in Switzerland in Migros. A lot of people said, no, we don't agree, nya, nya, nya. To me, it really smells like this. It smells like dried mangoes, but also it's like suave. I don't know how to say, like, if you put this on a beach, it's a summery fragrance, but it's also very, very sweet and like almost sickening, but it would give you almost like a body odor, but provoked by the sun. I'm getting too deep, guys, I'm telling you. Oh my god. Okay, so Tom Ford or Kid Salade. So this has a note that I don't like, tuberose. But overall, I really like it. It's very oily. It's a summer fragrance that is, it's not tropical. It's just very, very solar. And it's also animalic. Honestly, this one for summer ticks all the boxes for me. It's very, very expensive smelling. I don't even know how to explain it. Yeah, animalic, like oily. Like you spend all day on the beach with the most expensive lotion ever. Ever. Then I have two Montale fragrances. So this one, Intense Café. So this is a rosewood perfume. This Accord was very popular the whole year, I feel like. Rosewood Accord with like a kind of smoky coffee notes. I think this one is amazing. Totally worth it. Every time I wear it, I feel like I smell amazing. When I smell myself, my clothes, everything just smells amazing. Definitely recommend this one. It is a safe blind buy from Montale as long as you like oriental fragrances. That was like a low blow, come on. Oh, okay, last but not least, Mukh Khalat. I absolutely love this one, like plastic strawberry vanilla. I'm not always in the mood for that, but I feel like it is so original, like ridiculously original, that it definitely deserves its place here. It literally smells strange, like plastic strawberry. Yes. People say doll head, but what do they mean, like actually Barbie's head? I don't know when I last smelled that, but whatever. This is just like a drug. Absolutely love it. And also, you know what? I don't wear it a lot because you really have to be in the mood for that. But I know some people who literally insulted me because I recommended it and they bought it because of my recommendations. But other people say it's strange. It's very, very divided. I feel like it's a love or hate. It's a love or hate perfume. Okay, guys, I literally need to eat something because I think I'm just going in rounds and rounds and rounds. As I said in the last video, this is going to be a hard month for me. So, yeah. Cannot wait, but I'm gonna try to keep it the most constant possible and I'm gonna try to find my road. Pistachio, no! Wait, my rabbit made it in my room. Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Tell me in the comments what are your niche favorite fragrances. Top 1, top 3, top 5. Please comment what did you think about this video. Like, subscribe, activate notification bell. I'm gonna wait until you do it. Okay, guys, see you in my next video. Bye.